Got a here two junk doors. I paid, I think, around $200 for both of them. So let's unbox it, see what's inside. There's a little bag in here. Nice packaging. Okay. What is this, napkins? Oh, no way, check this out. Look at this, some kind of boots. Maybe baseball, I have no idea. They're pretty hefty. Check this out. A mini vase, weird. Never know what you're gonna get a junk door. Oh my gosh, look at that. That's a bowl, ceramic bowl. That actually cool. And another ceramic thing over here. Some kind of rabbit. Okay, what else we got here? Blue stamp bills, pretty nice quality. Looking at the nice pattern over here of numbers. Nothing special, or it's not a star bill. Then you have your 2000 proof coin set. That's kind of cool. Doesn't worth a lot. Wow, check out this belt buckle. Too bad it's a bad quality. That is kind of cool. Oh, look, a duck. No way, this is a duck pencil sharpener. Weird gadgets out here. What else we got here? Pigeon. Glass one. Ooh, I see something awesome. We're getting some value up in here. Gonna break that. Ooh, nice. First of all, we got here $1 silver eagle. 2016. Melt value silver like 27.5 right now, so that's easily $30. And Morgan silver dollar. This is nice. Circulated 1921 is the most popular year, and it is a D though, so that's cool. Not the best quality, but it's pretty nice, and it comes in the case. Okay, looks like there's more stuff. What's in here? Ooh, more silver. That is awesome. It says sterling on the back over here, so I would test it just to make sure. 1947, I think this is like 40% silvers over here. Gold label, John Walker, added 18 years ago. Wow, this is pretty cool. I actually like the gold label or black label. That is awesome. I think it's whiskey or something. I don't remember what it's called. But yeah, there's a whole bunch of 5 cent silvers, 947, all of them. And I remember how much is a melt value, not that much. Wow, there's some good quality, 942, bunch of mercury dimes. Beautiful, I think it's $3 each melt value, so that's awesome. Okay, there's a bunch of vintage pictures over here. Guess some people collect them, maybe. Look, a donkey. Okay, this is the most random junk door over here. Vintage matches, people collect those. So there's some value in them right here, especially if you have a pile. You can sell them as a lot pretty easily. There you go, another pigeon. What is that? Union Pacific Railroad. Interesting. So some kind of railroad mixer spoons. Somebody went on a train and saved it for themselves. Bunch of marbles. Looks like a bunch of half dollars, if I can open it. 50 cents, because it's 1973. Bishop Daniel, 1971, 1974, 1971. So this right here, dollar, $2, $3, $5. I'm gonna go spend it, $5. There you go, return. And there's an elephant, pretty cool. Artwork over here, and that's it. Now we're gonna go to the next junk door. I think this is 1940s 1 cent coins. Cool. Okay, bunch of most likely generic jewelry. I don't see 925 sterling. That's what you wanna look for. But yeah, that looks like non-silver for sure. Just bunch of junk generic silver right here. What else we got here? This one seems to be probably a lot more of them is silver. I'll look at it at the end. Oh wow, check this out. 1987 PCGS MS69. I don't know why they grade these things, but still, graded is a little bit more expensive sometimes. So this is probably like $50 over here. Pretty good quality. Graded coins a lot more worth than this one, because sending off to for grading you gotta pay. Depends where you send it off to, sometimes more expensive. This side here, flakes, nothing. 1 cent, 1957. I don't know why they put this 1 cent into this kind of folders. It's only worth like 1 cent. 1 cent. This side here, pennies, 50s, 1950s most likely. That's cool. Oh wow, there is some good stuff in here. Whole bunch of silver coins. We got silver. That's junk. Okay, wow, the 1923 peace dollar. 1923 peace dollar, bad quality, but melt value. I remember like $18. It goes up and down like crazy, especially now, so volatile. A half dollar melt value, $8. $8. That one kind of good quality. Never mind, 1962. It's a bit up. So all these are melt value, $8 each. That's nice. Quarter, I think melt value is like $6. But I could be wrong, you guys could look it up. So a bunch of junk silver over here, 90% silver, super nice. Okay, I see more coins. So looks like we got here like a junk drawer of coins almost. This one kind of nice, that's a good quality. That's why they put it in there. And I see the old 1955s. But I feel like there's so many good qualities out there of them, so I don't think they're worth that much. Okay, more jewelry. I doubt any of this is silver, but let's look into it. Close the spin. Yep, so a bunch of watches inside. Okay, wow, look how much we got. A Bitcoin, yeah, 32,000. I'm just joking, Bitcoin is digital, but this is just copper Bitcoin. That is actually really cool. That is so unique. Check this out. 1 ounce copper coin, probably like $3 or $4. There's a copper one and bunch of pennies. Ooh, check this out, bunch of graded coins. But I don't really like the graded. If it's PCG S graded, that's awesome. This one, I don't know nothing about these graders, but still, this is a bunch of proof coins. Oh, there you go, this one's the good graders. You see PCGS, that's what you want. PR69, wow, very nice. And this one is PR69. I love these graded coins, people like them. There's always market for that. I don't know, a couple bucks easily. So there's some holidays earrings, and that's it. So this is what I got in a junk drawer this time. Super unique stuff over here this time. I really like it. And we got a Bitcoin, copper. I don't have one, so I kind of want to put it in a case. Maybe take this one out and put this one in a case instead. But yeah, super cool. But I think I have a bunch of casing. Okay, I think this is all generic as well. You could just tell it's kind of like falling off. I could go through it, but you could just tell this is not silver.